Hello, React Native developers. I hope you are well. William here, recording from beautiful Zurich, Switzerland. When building animations in React Native, the key to success is to avoid frame drops, which means that we have only 16 milliseconds or 8 milliseconds in some cases to render everything. And we do it by declaring all of our gestures and animations on the UI thread so that they can run smoothly independently of the JavaScript thread being busy or not. We use the animated API to declare which properties need to be updated on the UI thread. Some properties are going to be updated directly, and some properties are going to be updated via the React UI manager because they're going to affect the layout of other elements. If we take animated.view, for instance, a property like transform can be updated directly because it's not going to change the layout of other elements, but the property like height and width need to be updated via the UI manager because they might affect the layout of other elements. And this distinction can be quite important in some use cases, as you will see. Now, in this video, I would like to show you a couple of examples where the animation model is not so straightforward. What if you're trying to animate the children of a component and not a property? Or what if you're trying to animate a component that relies on an imperative API and not the traditional React declarative model? Let's have a look. When building complex animations in React Native, we need to make sure that things run on the same schedule. So if you have properties which are updated directly and properties which are updated via the UI manager, things might get out of sync. We've noticed it on the iPod example, where updating the color of the text was done via the UI manager and updating the background color of the row was done directly, and things would get out of sync. So here in this example, we display the two texts overlaid on top of each other, and we just play on the opacity of one or the other to give the impression of a single text changing color. Here is the circular slider example, which is a mix of SVG animations and view animations. So the cursor, the knob here, is animated via a view, and the circle is an SVG animation. And this is running on an old version of Reanimated, where by default, and this was a bug, by default, the SVG elements would be animated via the UI manager, which don't really make sense because they're not going to affect the layout of other elements. And so you can see here we have properties that are updated on the UI thread directly and some via the UI manager, and they get out of sync. So the knob is out of sync with the animation of the circle. Now, if we run the same example on the latest version of Reanimated, all the properties are animated directly, including the SVG ones, and so things cannot get out of sync. So here it doesn't matter how fast I move my finger, the knob will be always perfectly in sync with the progress of the circle. So a nice bug fix from Reanimated I was pretty excited about. What about animating text like this graph value here? The text component receives its text value as a children because text components can be nested with one another, which can make it hard to animate because it's not a property. Johnny Burger forked the whole text implementation in a package that you can use to animate text via an attribute. In Redash, we play a trick because there's a second component in React Native we can use to display text, and it's text input, and this time it relies on the property which is named value, so something that we know how to animate. Here, we need to be extra careful because this component is not symmetric with the text component, so it's not going to behave exactly the same way. And here, we built an example where we animate on the value property. The interesting thing here is that if you do this, nothing will happen, because the underlying native component doesn't know about a value property. This is the JavaScript implementation. By introspecting the text input component, we found out that it's the text attribute that can be updated. So here we use create animated prop adapter to match the value property to the text property, and we can use it in animated prop. so that React Reanimated knows which property to update. And you see here, it updates nicely. React Native provides us with a way to introspect a component to find the underlying native component and which properties can be animated on the UI thread. So here I created a text input component and I can use find host instance to find the name of the underlying native component as well as the list of properties that can be animated. So here I have single line text input view, and if I check out the list of properties, there is a text property. So I know that I can animate on this property, and therefore this is why we use the create animated prop adapter to map the value property to the text property. The animated API is enabling us to build these high performance animation use cases, but it can also be used to simply describe a value that needs to be updated outside the React life cycle. And I would like to show you an example from the last Can It Be Done in React Native video where we have this nice SVG animation for the graph below, but updating the OpenGL Canva has to be done on the JavaScript thread. The way we did it was quite convoluted. First, we had to set the default uniforms properties. Interestingly enough, this is exactly what Reanimated 2 does for its own animations. And then we had to listen to changes in the value, call back to the JavaScript thread, and use set draw props that is enabling us to update the uniforms of the OpenGL Canva and bypassing React completely. So quite a convoluted implementation. What if we could use the animated API directly for such a use case? We are not going to get better performance because for OpenGL, we need to use the JavaScript thread at the moment, no matter what. But we're going to get a unified API to describe any values that need to be updated outside the React lifecycle. So here, I created a small patch for create animated component. By default, if a component cannot be updated on the UI thread, Reanimated 2 resorts on using set native prop to update the component. So here we simply pass an adapter. So we receive the ref of the component and the properties. And we know that for OpenGL, we need to use set draw props. So here I give the mapping between set native props and what needs to be done to update the property of the component outside the React lifecycle. And here I can simply use animated node and I have my animated props. So the implementation of the picture component is much simpler. It looks exactly how it would look like if the properties were animated on the UI thread. So the performance hasn't been improved, but now we really use a unified API for updating any values outside the React lifecycle. Here is an example with the raw GLView API. So we have to animate through the JavaScript thread, but we want to use a unified API. So we have the progress value, which is a shared value from Reanimated, but then we can leverage it to build our OpenGL animation via create animated component and the set native prop adapter, where we're going to receive the progress value on every frame, and we can use it to build our OpenGL animation. So again, here, the performance hasn't been improved, but we're using the same animation values that we know and love and a unified API for animations. That's it. I wanted to show you these three examples. First, if you have a complex animation where some of the properties might be updated via the UI manager, you need to be careful that they don't get out of sync with the properties which are being updated directly. And you really need to understand which properties you are updating and maybe play some tricks in order to achieve the expected result. And then we looked at some odd animation properties, the text component, for instance, which rely on a children for the text value, which is not a property we can animate. Johnny Burger forked the text component so we can use it with animation values. In Redash, we play a trick. We use the text input, which can be animated through the value property. And we used the create adapter from Reanimated 2 to map the JavaScript property value to the native property text. And finally, we looked at the animated API as a way to describe any sort of value that can be updated outside the React lifecycle. In the case of OpenGL animation, things need to be animated on the JavaScript thread no matter what for now. But by using the animated API, we just have a nice and unified way to describe these values that need to be updated outside the React lifecycle. Guys, I am looking forward to talk to you soon. And until next time, happy hacking.